gets this young boy, because it's so strange to think that we've jumped into a society where people, where children are getting into trouble for acknowledging reality. And this really happened to this young boy. He was sent home from school. He is only 12 years old, and he was sent home because he wore a t-shirt that said, "There are only two genders."
Wow.
This is a Massachusetts middle
That's
school
crazy,
student.
Bro.
His name is Liam
That's
Morrison.
That's
and I want you to listen
crazy.
To him recounting this in his own words.
That's crazy.
T-shirt that said, "There are only two genders." This is a Massachusetts middle school student. His name is Liam Morrison. And I want you to listen to him recounting this in his own words to the school board.
Wokeism is bad, bro. Detrimental.
7th, 10th grade at Nichols Middle School. I appreciate the opportunity to speak to you today. I never thought the shirt I wore to school on March 21st would lead me to speak with you today. On that Tuesday morning, I was taken out of gym class to sit down with two adults for what turned out to be a very uncomfortable talk. I was told that people were complaining about the words on my shirt.
Wow.
My shirt was making some students feel
The irrefutable
unsafe.
Truth.
Yes.
It's hatred in the eyes of certain people.
They told me that
certain
I wasn't
people.
In trouble, but it sure felt like I was. I was told that I would need to remove my shirt before I could return to class.
Wow.
But I nicely told them that I didn't want to do that.
Mm-hmm.
They called my father. Thankfully, my dad supported my decisions.
Shout out to you and your father, my guy.
What did my shirt say? Five simple words. There are only two genders.
The irrefutable truth.
Just a statement.
Not odious.
Fact. I have been told that my shirt was targeting a protected class. Who is this protected class? Are their feelings more important than my rights?
Nope.
I don't complain when I see pride flags and diversity posters hung throughout the school. Do you know why? Because others have a
marginalized,
right to just as I do.
Oppressed.
Not one person, staff, or student told me that they were bothered by what I was wearing.
Trans
Actually,
community.
Just the opposite. Several kids told me that they supported my actions and that they wanted one too. I was told that the shirt was a disruption to learning. No one got up and stormed out of class. No one burst into tears. I'm sure I would have noticed if they had. I experienced disruptions to my learning every day. Kids acting out in class are a disruption, yet nothing is done.
Wow.
Why do the rules apply to one, yet not another?
Mm.
I feel like
Bias.
The adults were telling me that it wasn't okay for me to have an opposing view. Their arguments were weak, in my opinion. I didn't go to school that day to hurt feelings or cause trouble. I learned a lot from this experience. I learned that a lot of other students share my view.
Mm.
I learned that adults don't always do the right thing or make the right decisions. I know that I have a right to wear the shirt with those five words.
Mm-hmm.
Even at 12 years old, I have my own political opinions, and
mm-hmm.
I have a right to express those opinions.
Yeah.
Even
Facts.
At school, this right is called the First Amendment to the Constitution.
Freedom of
my
speech.
My hope in being here tonight is to bring the school committee's
Freedom
attention to this
of
issue.
Expression.
I hope that you will speak up for the rest of us. This right is called the First Amendment to the Constitution. My hope in being here tonight is to bring the school committee's attention to this issue. I hope that you will speak up for the rest of us so we can express ourselves without being pulled out of class. Next time, it may not only be me. There might be more students that decide to speak out. Thank you for your time and good night.
Just such an incredible speech. So well written.
I concur.
Articulate.
Intelligent.
And here's the reality.
Civilized.
If you are a child and you follow the rules, if you are a child and you believe in reality,
logicality,
you now can face consequences.
You get branded
right?
a transphobe, anti-trans
so
person, an anti-trans person.
Mental illness that they're starting to punish people who don't have it. I like that he points to the fact that people are allowed to fly their pride parade. That is their belief. Maybe this young boy is a Christian. Is he allowed to say that he finds it to be disruptive to his learning environment when he sees somebody wearing a pride flag? Absolutely not. They would tell them that this is a protected space. The truth is that they're willing to protect every strange, mentally ill group, but they will not protect people who believe in reality. That's the truth. That is the entire circumstance in America, that if there's nothing wrong with you, you are somebody that is a threat to everybody else. And we are living in a live, insane asylum. I love that you talk about how there's disruptions, people fist fight, people that are arguing, people that are talking in class, and nobody cares.
Spinelessness, softness.
Yes, day in and day out. Yet he wore a shirt, a basic fact.
Within
fact,
the people in power.
Wear it. He should have been learning it
in the schools.
He should have been learning in school what you're sending him to.
They're not punishing the right people, bro. They're punishing the wrong people. They're punishing the people that are civilized, that are rooted in reality, that are saying the irrefutable truth, the indisputable reality, bro.
Yes, day in and day out. Yet he wore a shirt, a basic fact. The fact, he shouldn't have had to wear it. He should have been learning it in school. He should have been learning in school what you're sending him to, if the school is basing itself in reality.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man.